You never know where life will take you. One day you're living in the fast lane, the next you're living in a van with your young son on the side of a road.
I used to fly to Vancouver and visit my girlfriend and rent a private jet, and you know, we were doing well, worked hard.
Life was pretty good for Joseph, running a profitable lumber business on the family farm in central Saanich, but after a family dispute and lawyer fees, he was left with nothing.
At first it was devastating, because when a man loses his ability to look after himself and his family, it's emotionally was really tough.
Joseph and Zachary, who was just 3 years old at the time and has a hearing challenge, began collecting pop cans to survive.
When they could afford it, Joseph would bring his son here to this chocolate shop on East Saanich Road for a little treat. One day, little Zach said something that would change everything.
I was really upset and crying, and I thinking, how did I get here, and what are we going to do? And Zach was three, and he put his hand on my shoulder and he said, "It's okay, Dad. Just pretend we're camping. It's okay." And it really struck me like a bolt of lightning. And I thought, you know what? We can look at it differently. We can think differently about our situation.
From then on, instead of spending all their pop bottle money, Joseph began to save 15%. They quickly managed to save nearly $500.
We had an old burgundy Dodge van. Didn't have any insurance, but we would move it up and down the street so it didn't look like it was derelict.
Joseph met a single mom who took him and his son into her home. Joseph began using his savings to buy and sell items he found in the classifieds. In 8.5 months, he saved $100,000.
We ended up buying the farm back within the year, and we moved out there with the gals. For a man, it was like grabbing the trophy. And it was a good goal, something to go after.
Soon after they all moved back to the farm, the woman that had taken in Joseph and Zach decided to move to Europe. Each day for the last 100 days they were together, Joseph wrote her a letter or a poem expressing his gratitude and love.
We never got in touch again or contacted, or so I don't know what ever happened to her.
6 years went by, and Joseph decided to show the letters to a friend he had met who was a book publicist. She was so impressed by Joseph's story and writings, she encouraged him to get them published. Zach got an idea.
He said, "How much would it cost? Really cost us?" And I said, "Well, if we do it ourselves, we can do it for probably under $1,000. So he says, "Well, Dad, I still got my pop bottle money from, because we never stopped collecting pop bottles and cans, because I wanted Zach to learn about the value of money."
And just like that, 100 Days of Love was published and is now selling all over the world.
So you must be pretty proud of your dad.
Yeah, I am. And I'm also proud of myself because I went through a lot that most kids wouldn't go through at that age.
If you're having difficulty or life does not seem to be giving you what you want, sometimes we have to stop asking what life is going to give us and ask, what can we give to life?